Thank you, Dilip, for a wonderful introduction. And I'd like to thank Dilip for inviting me to speak here at the University of the FCAC. It's a great privilege. I'd also like to thank Sam Hirschman for giving you all the background information on what a big problem credit card debt is. My research, and this research was published in the Journal of Consumer Research in 2016, so you don't need to take pictures of the slides. The paper exists. Please email me if you'd like a copy. We look at how debt repayment strategy affects mortgage. So I'm going to give you a little stylized example here. We know that most consumers have problematic debt and more than one debt. So here, which debt should you repay first? Well, we have different interest rates. Smaller account, $500 is a higher interest rate. This probably replicates what a lot of consumers experience. They might have a credit line, a larger amount than a credit card. I'd say most people would agree that they probably want to pay off account B first. Higher credit rating, smaller account. What if they're the same rate? Well, perhaps we have the econs are now panicking, so they don't know what to do. Perhaps we have a behavioral who says, well, you know, that $500 would really like to get to that. Scott has a paper that says people are averse to accounts, well, we'll get rid of B. So most of us would probably go for B. Well, what if it was close? What would we do here? So we're interested in the behavioral side of this, not the rational, optimal decision. And we began our research by looking at debt repayment as a goal. So here's a stylized example. This person has $5,000 in debt over five credit cards. How should they repay that? This person, we assume most indebted consumers have a goal to get out of debt. So we might consider this to be an overarching or super burdening goal. But within that, they have individual or sub-goals to repay each debt individually. Okay? So how do sub-goals work? We know there's a lot of research on them. So it's an easy example. Imagine you're running a marathon or a 10K. Here we're running a marathon. You have a long-term goal, super burdening goal of finishing the race, or if you're a better runner than I am, you might have a certain time that you're desiring. That's a long way off, right? So you don't think, oh, okay, I've only got 40 kilometers to go. Instead, you might create sub-goals. You say, okay, I have a goal to finish the first mile or first mile in 5 minutes. Okay? And sub-goals work because they're closer, they're more approximate. Your definition, they're easier to maintain. Okay, so we use sub-goals, and we know that they motivate us to achieve the super market goal. Now, one difference between debt and running is you have to run in a certain order, right? You can't complete mile 39 before mile 1. But with debt, you can repay any debt in any order you want. So we're going to delineate between two types of strategies here. One we call a dispersed strategy. So dispersed strategy, imagine this, you have $500 repay, and you spread it more or less equally over different accounts. As Sam suggested, this is what a lot of research suggests that consumers tend to do. Or you do engage in what's called a concentrated strategy. So we're going to focus on repaying one debt as much as we can. So we have conducted a few experiments. We have some field data. We share the field data with you first, in which we look at whether and how a concentrated strategy might motivate people to repay their debt faster than a dispersed strategy. So we got this credit card data from a wonderful organization called HelloWallet. They're a personal finance app. All these apps. What's good about HelloWallet, and this is not a pitch for HelloWallet, but what was good about this data was they're sold to Fortune 500 companies, so their clients are not actually consumers. Consumers use them, but they're funded to pay by Fortune 500 companies as a employee benefit. So they don't use advertising, so our data is fairly clean. And what we wanted to do with this data was first see if we can measure repayment strategy in the real world. And also, again, test to see if, sorry about that, if the concentrated strategy predicts subsequent debt repayment. So, for those of you who like the Greek alphabet, you're very excited. For the rest of you, I'm going to explain this in English. This is a measure that's very similar. What was presented earlier. It's a measure between 0 and 1 of the distribution of dispersion of payments. So, in English, basically, we're going to get a value between 0 and 1, and it's the variance of the payments divided by the average payment. So, what does that mean? Well, here's a person who has two debt repayments. They have repaid debt A and B, and they give 5 to each. So that has a variance of 0, because the numbers are exactly the same. So we have a measure of concentration, which calls for this person's a perfectly dispersed strategy. You can use this measure as well for those who work for banks to measure how concentrated and dispersed the debts are, right? It doesn't have to be a debt repayment amount, it can be an actual debt number, you get the same. So if we double our debt repayments to 10, we still have a perfectly dispersed strategy. We get a measure of 0. By conversely, if we have all of our payment into one account is in example three. Then we get a measure of our value of one, in order to increase the amount. I have another slide which I deleted. We can show you for 3, 4, 5, 6 accounts. So we can actually measure the extent to which individual consumers use and disperse a concentrated strategy. And of course, there's numbers between 0 and 1 that you get depending on how much you allocate to the account. So our data, we had to, or we intentionally excluded people who only had one credit card. So we only looked at people who only had one credit card. So, I mean, nothing against those people who have a credit card. They're fine people, I'm sure. But we can't measure debt repayment strategy for a person with one credit card. We have to compete with multiple credit cards. So here's a dispersion of how concentrated debts are. This is not the repayments, this is their debts. You see this on the left-hand side are people with multiple credit cards. Our average was 3.5 credit cards. Since people on the left-hand side, most people have 3 credit cards with reasonably equal amounts of debt on each. And now there's a bit of a bimodal distribution. The people on the right-hand side have one large credit card and a few smaller ones. Okay? So we're going to look at how concentrated people's debt payments are. Well, we see a real bimodal distribution. I was actually smiling when Bill put up his slides. So that was the same thing I am. Not exactly, but as we can see, there's a large group of people on the left-hand side who use basically a perfectly dispersed strategy. They take the money every month and allocate it across credit cards. On the right-hand side, there's a small group that do have a concentrated repayment strategy, right? So they seem to tend to want to pay them one account at a month, or one account at a time. Now, we analyzed with thousands of customers, tens of thousands of months of data. So what we did was we took a person's debt payments over the month and put them all together. I want to highlight that our effects are what we call within subject. Those are your stats people, we use effects model. And what that means is that we're not going to compare, so let's say Nicole is a concentrated strategy person, and Scott is a dispersed strategy person. We need to talk. We're not comparing whether Nicole repays her debt faster than Scott. What we're looking at is whether Nicole repays her debt faster if she uses a slightly more concentrated versus slightly more dispersed strategy. So we're looking within person. Okay? So to preempt your question of, well, are people, what else is predicting this? This is within person. Okay? So here's our exciting model effects. I'll just guide you through them. Basically, the more concentrated a person's debt repayment strategy in a 1 month, month T, the more they repay their debt in the following month. Very exciting. And you have a bunch of controls. So this, is invariant to how much they've repaid in the past. It's invariant to how much debt they have, how much they spend each month in their birth cards, closing an account. We have all kinds of controls here. And it doesn't matter whether their accounts were more or less concentrated, right, if their actual debt was spread out. So it's a debt repayment strategy that's motivating greater debt repayment. So the fielding, we have several experiments that show the same pattern of results. Using a more concentrated strategy within the same person led them to a greater debt repayment in the subsequent period. So what explains this effect? Well, it's really about feelings of progress. Imagine you're running this marathon, right? And every step feels pretty small in the context of 40 kilometers or 26 miles. However, the first mile, those steps feel like you're getting closer to that first mile as compared to the 26th mile. So to test this, we had a bunch of scenarios. These are some stylized examples. So this is going back to the example you gave me at the beginning. So we said, well, here's a situation. You have two debts, $4,500 and $500. And imagine that you repaid a certain amount to each. How much progress do you make for repaying your debt? So here we have the person who's got a concentrated repayment of $300 into their biggest account. And they're at 3.57. On a scale of 1 to 7, that's pretty low, actually. Or we could concentrate it into the smaller repayment, or smaller amount, and they feel that they made much more progress. Okay? And that progress is motivated, right? If I feel like I'm getting closer to repaying my debts, again, the total amount of the debts, total amount of repayment is exactly the same. Now you might say, well, Keri, the researcher, I see that in the bottom one, they finish off their $200, they're close to repaying their debts. So we had other scenarios where they finished off at the same amount, right? So it doesn't matter where they end up, it's the perception that they're getting closer to repaying the debt. They're making progress, even though all of the other numbers are exactly the same. So it explains the effect of making a concentrated debt repayment strategy on motivation to pay debt is that people feel like they're making greater progress if they're allocating as much money as they can from one account, and ideally for smallest debt account. So back to our question, which debt should you repay first? Well, I wish I could give you an answer. I can't. Unfortunately, data doesn't tell us well. You pay it 5% faster, 10% faster. I will say this, though. The answer to this question is not obvious, and it depends on how big we believe or you expect the ability motivation to take.